Video. Why can't I get that? No. I'm gonna redo that. Hello, everyone. Welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, I am Krissy with two sheep, one wheat, and on this channel, it is everything board games. You can watch me play board games and you can hear me talk about board games. If that sounds like it is up your alley, then why don't you hit that subscribe button down below so that you don't miss my next video. Today's video, I'm going to be talking to you about, where did I put my box? About the game Parks. And if you stick around till the end, you'll even hear about what I think about it. Let's get started. So here's the game, it is all set up. In Parks, you are 1 to 5 hikers trekking through the trails, all through the 4 different seasons and through different weather, all to visit parks while collecting points along the way. So I'll get started with the player setup. So player setup, there is no board, there is nothing, but you do get cards. You get some cards, you get some pretty cool little tokens, and this little thing here, a fire. You get a fire, and if you look here, it's purple, the same as my little trekkers here. So for the two-player game that I have set up here, I picked purple for myself, and I picked green for my opponent. We'll call him George. So my hikers are already getting ready to go. So I have placed myself as first player. You get this awesome, cool metal first player token. So in the two-player game, the second player would get the camera. Now in a regular three-player game, four-player game, the person who is on the right to the person with the first player token gets the camera to start with. Now you also get these cards here. These are called calendar cards. You actually get 2 of them at the beginning. You flip them over secretly. Don't let anybody see them. They are personal bonuses. So you have 2 of them. You get to pick which one you want. And these just give you extra points towards the end. This one here says visit 6 parks worth 2 to 3 points each. And if you look right here, look at that. There's 2 on the board. So this would be a good one to keep, I think. So you'd flip that over. Let's check out George's. Have 7 suns worth of gear. Oh, that's not too bad. Hopefully more of these pink ones come out because they are worth 3. So along with that, you get these canteens here. The canteens, you would use a resource to get another resource, but it would have to be the water resource that you would use. So you can actually find these on the board as well, just up here. Except these two, look at that right on top. Most of them are for resources. Oh, that's another one too. So this one here, you would be able to just switch resources for different resources. And this one, you can switch a resource to get one of the wilds, the wildlife resource, or you could reserve a card, a park. Then you have the season cards. Season cards are basically just an extra little help that you can get during the seasons. So every season this will switch over as well. So this one gains 1 sun if you gain any trees on a turn. That's pretty cool. And then why don't we just talk about these parks one here. So the parks, as you can see, there's a bunch of different ones. So you get 3 on the board and you would pay the cost, the resources, to visit one of these parks. This one has 4 water, this one has 4 water and 3 mountains, but it is worth 5, so that one's pretty good too. And this one, 1 mountain and 2 suns. Now you have these gears here, these gear cards. There are 3 different colors, the yellow, the blue. Oh, they have a green. What am I talking about? 3 different colors. Looks like they got a couple of colors. That's cool. So these ones, I would say that getting these ones early on in the game would be beneficial. since they kind of give you a little bit of help here throughout the game. So this one, you can gain a wildlife instead of two suns on this card here. This one, you may also exchange two resources to take a picture. Now, on this board here, this is where your hikers go through the trails, going up mountains and through fields to get to the end. So your little hiker here will go, and we'll say we'll go to this sun one here. So this one, if you did have this one, then you would gain a wild instead of the two suns, which is pretty cool. But while you're down here trekking through these trails, you actually have to watch out for the weather. Now the weather is actually on the weather cards. So if you look right here, I'll hold this up for you. If you look right here, ooh, Monday looks like it's gonna be sunny, Tuesday is sunny, but Wednesday is rainy. So you actually follow this pattern here and you place it on your trail. So what that does is just gives you an extra bonus when you land on there. So let's just see, you would skip placing it on that one. Put on that one, this one, water on this one, sun on this one, and another sun on the last one. Now the beginning and the end trails don't get any of these. So now that you have these, the first person on them, let's just keep going with this one here with the two suns. The first person on this tile would actually collect this bonus. Now nobody else can go on that one, unless this is where the fire comes in handy. Now usually you wouldn't be able to go on there, but if you still have your fire lit, you would actually be able to go there as well if you wanted to collect this bonus, say because there's a pretty good gear card that you want. Now all you would have to do is flip that over. You exhausted your fire. You're basically just using your opponent's fire to stay warm that night on that site. So the first person to get to the end of the trail has a couple of different options here. You can either reserve a card or reserve a park to go visit. Now, whenever that happens, you can either take it from the top of the deck or you could reserve one of the three that are on the board. What you would do is just place it in front of you like this, indicating that it is just reserved and you haven't actually paid the cost to get into the park yet. But when you do that, you also get the first player token. Now I find that that's pretty cool that they stuck that there, because at the end of the four seasons, after a year has been gone, or after a year has gone by, this is actually worth one victory point towards the end. Now say that spot is taken, you can still go there to reserve a park, but you just don't get that effect. You don't get the ability to gain the first player token. But you can also buy the gear cards from here as well, and the first person on that one gains a sun resource. And then the third option on here is to actually visit the parks by using the resources that you have collected. Now, once everybody has gotten to the end of the trail, now let's just say purple is tagging behind here. Not that you should ever leave anybody behind in a trail, but let's just say, because it is a game, that purple, the second hiker, has been left behind. If all of the other hikers arrived at the end trail, now this person is running to catch up. So it doesn't get to go to any of these other stops here. It directly goes to the end of the trail, which kind of, you can kind of trigger the end of the round, right? So that maybe you wanted to go first or something and you wanted to buy a card or visit a park for the points. So you can kind of do that too. Now, while you are trekking through here, if you notice this one, I did mention it earlier, paying two resources to take a picture. Now, the person who has the camera, if you flip this around, it shows that you only need to pay the cost of one resource to take a picture. If you do not have the camera, you can still take a picture, but it would cost two resources. But then you essentially steal this from the player. And at the end of this, this triggers the end round, right? So you would come over here and it would follow. back on the board over here, you can follow everything that you need to do to refresh for the season. So you actually, whoever has this at the end of the season, gets to actually do it again. They can pay one resource to take another picture, which comes in handy because I will show you here. These are the pictures which actually go with the same on the park cards, which is pretty cool, the pictures. So these are actually worth 1 point at the end of the game too. I think that this is probably the second way to gain the most points other than visiting all these parks. So that is triggered by the end and the cleanup and the get ready for the next season, right? So if you look here, you can see once this is all done, these should be all taken. If not, you can put them back. So what you would do then is it comes with these extra cards, and these are the kind of the season rounds, right? So at the end of every season, then you would refresh and you would add an extra tile. Now you take all these tiles, you shuffle them, and you put them back. Then, of course, the weather refreshes because it is a different season. So you would get rid of this card, you would flip it over, and then it is sun, rain, sun, rain, sun, rain. And then you get kind of an extra turn. So it adds, by the end of the year, you're gaining an extra round turn every time. So it elongates it, which is pretty cool. So then that's what you would do to refresh your turn. And like I said, at the end, once you come here, then you can take your pictures. And then your canteen here, once you gain a water from the trail, you place it here and you get another resource. So if you did use that, then that is the time that you would put it back. And then you start fresh for the next season. Then you move all of your hikers back to the beginning of the trail, and then they have to do it all over again. But that's okay, that's fine. So that is basically it. You would continue to do that for the second round, the third round, the fourth round, and that would be a year. So then at the end, it even tells you right here how you count your points. So you would count all of the cards here. All of your parks that you visited would have this victory point. So you would count all of your parks, and then you would count your personal bonuses. Let's just say I only got one. Well, I am not getting this bonus here at all, but it is just points, just 2 points. So that is okay. I would be okay with that. But then let's just say I got all of these pictures. All of these are worth 1 point. So you would count all of these as well. All of them. And then the first player, whoever ended up with the first player token at the end, would also get 1 point. So that is how you would win. And that is how you kind of play it too. Now, a couple of things that make me enjoy this game. One, it's the tokens and the trays that it comes in, because that is awesome. You got all these wooden tokens here, all these resources. They are the same color as what they're supposed to be. Like the sun is yellow, it's not blue, but the water is blue. And then I just wanted to mention these wildlife resources. They are all different, but they are wild. They're wild animals. It's wildlife. They're wild tokens. They can be used as any other resources. That was smart thinking. Whoever came up with that, pretty smart. Pretty smart. And then, obviously, my second point to why I love this game. Well, I would have to say the artwork, would I not? Literally everything revolves around camping, hiking, trails, like right down to canteens, buying gear that help you later on in your game. All of the artwork on these cards, I'm gonna have to go through these with you, because like, look at this. Tell me that this is not cool. And then something that I just realized too, I'll take this one here. These cards, it tells you what the parks are. It actually tells you when they were established. This one was in 1940. And it actually tell you who the designer, whoever drew this or created this, it has their name on it. And it actually gives you a little bit of the park itself too, down at the bottom. It says Isle Royale is the largest island in Lake Superior. The park contains 400 smaller islands and the surrounding waters. Like, how cool is that? Literally. I think there are 45 different national parks from the US listed and shown in this game. And I think they took 40 different like designers, creators, and this is all of their work. Like, look at this. And the resources kind of have to go with what is on the card too, like the sun because it's got the sky, and water because it's got water and trees, it's in the forest, it's got mountains. Oh, but this one doesn't have a mountain, but this one does. Oh, look, we found the one from the box. But look at this. Oh, that one is beautiful. And you know what? Not only do just these cards have all of this artwork. Oh my gosh, look at this one. When you play a game, you don't go through that many of these because you have to pay the cost, right? So you're not going through many of these. I think this one is my favorite. I'll leave that one lifted up there. But not only are these cards full of artwork, the back of all of these cards, the front of all of these cards all have different artworks on them as well. And the canteens. And I even want to show the rule book. Like, the rule book has all of the artwork too. Like, I don't know if you can see this, but it is actually on the cards or on the pages as well. All of it, everything, the tiles, the pictures that you're taking, everything. And another thing too is that it kind of comes with a player aid, which we all know that that's my thing. It did just come with one, and it's kind of just a card or a piece of paper, but it still works. I still enjoy it. Now, it is a light game. It does go pretty quick. I think it said 40 to 70 minutes, but I'm pretty sure that we played it under 40 minutes. So it's easy. There is a little bit of thinking involved though, because there are so many different things that you are looking at. But overall, if you had a chance to play this game, I would suggest that you do it. You feel like you're in it, like you're looking at it, and you feel like you're going through the forest, and you're not even leaving your couch or your chair. Which is the best part of it, I think. I think I'm funny. So anyway, if you had a chance to play this game, I would suggest that you do it. And if you do have it, and if you do play it, why don't you let me know below if you did and what you think of it, if you liked it or not. So anyway, this was my overview and my review all in one. Hopefully you made it to the end here and you enjoyed what you saw. I will catch you guys next video. Wait, what? What is happening? What is happening? I don't understand this.